They're going to need more than that.
I mean, actually, there are lots of teams to take examples from as well as we look at the knife. So, for example, Titan, they have a let's take Titan as the example, because I'm you know, just imagine that. For example, you've got Kenny S. He very clearly in their picking strategies, he will be picking up the AWP and he'll be making things happen for the team whilst they have a passive opening, burning the first 40 seconds of the round, playing passively against any pushes, allowing also Kenny S time to get a pick at the start of the round to then allow them to play off of that pick. So this is like a team where, for example, you have a really good AWPer, you want to use him. I feel like that's a good kind of approach when you have someone like Skadoodle on your team, because Skadoodle is such a solid AWPer. Aggressively, defensively, just across the board, he is a really impressive player. And, I mean, Cloud9 must be so happy they picked him up. And of course, you know, especially with the whole NA kind of like shuffle thing, like Skadoodle and Hiko lurking around and Hiko getting kind of like left in the cold and the rain, then...
Refugee Hiko.
It's pretty nice for Cloud9 that they managed to get that pick up indeed. So we'll have to see how well they can use him in this cast match. We're going to have the pistol round underway, and it looks like we are going to see an A retake opening from Cloud9. And they do have the single kit, and it is on Skadoodle.
Okay, so gone for the single rather than the triple, which we've seen today. It's going to be a molly, which I think lands in the kind of default plant spot slash headshot area. One of the two, if not both. Indeed, that's exactly where it is, both being covered there. So, first frag going to go away of Cloud9, although trades coming in now. Burst fire coming out for Rix to find his second frag of the day. Nice headshot there by Stanislaw. So, down to nothing versus three. We'll see if he can find himself the headshots.
Bomb is down now. We have nothing moved around by headshot. Looking for the shots. Going to pick off Stanislaw with a nice shot to the face. He's alone now, though, is nothing. All alone, going for the fake defuse, trying to bait somebody out. They're both going to peek it, and it's going to be easy. There was no stopping them. No stopping them. And you know what I fear for Cloud9, James? You know what I really fear?
What?
Glorious, when he decides that it's time to buy an auto-sniper. That's what I fear, James.
We'll see if it happens, but for now, double MP7, double Glil, single P90.
P90?
Yeah, P90. On Mr. Rix. So Shroud's closing the distance early with the CZ. He wants the headshots. He wants the one taps. But he will not be engaged just yet. But Shazam is in a scarily close proximity to that MP. Yeah. That CZ75.
And we have the P90 of Rix moving into A main now. P90 not to be confused with P90X. There shall be no workouts here. We're nerds. Skadoodle going for the jump shots right now. Back quad looking to abuse the scout. That is going to be incredibly hard to pick him off. Even if they're aiming on his head there as he's popping up, it's going to be really hard to get that going. But they have the Molotovs and the grenades
Look
going in.
Look at this flank from Shroud. He's starting to speed up as the push is coming in. He could get a serious spray down here. I've seen three-man spray downs before. There's the first one. Rick's going to get tagged. And he could pick up the P90. Or opt for the CZ, in fact, he will do that. Over the smoke, he will get shot straight in the face by Shazam. Lots of trades coming in favor of Cloud9. Now it's only Stanislaw remaining. Sean Grills will take down the final kill, and that will be the defuse here for Cloud9, straight onto the scoreboard after the pistol.
So that's a pretty sick survival there. Three players will be able to pick up weapons, so two Galils have been claimed for Cloud9. So this is a huge reset. The only thing that really is a consolation for Tempo Storm is picking up the bomb plants. So that will mitigate it's the damage done slightly to their economy, having been reset straight away after a full investment. So this round they'll get $1,900 after if they lose, in addition to what they have now, which will put them shy of 4K at best, I believe. So we will see at best, you know, AK armor with maybe a nade each in the following round, if I didn't miscalculate that. And well, Cloud9, they will be making the bank right now. Sean Gez getting the spray down, four players in a row.
Boom.
And it's just Hades who remains series, chilling by B storage. But there is not a lot of chilling to be done, because we're gonna roll up with the MP7 and be taking lives.
Well, that was a quick one now out of the way. And Cloud9 take a lead, but for how long?
James, castamath, hashtag castamath. Oh yes, let me pat myself on the back. I have no shame, do I?
What are you referring to?
Because I said that they would have 3900 4K, if I did the math right.
Congrats. Allow me to be the first to congratulate you, although I fear I will be the last, Dan.
Thank you. Oh, wow. Is Shroud going to go? Oh, my goodness. They're all pushing pot. Shroud is close with the MP9, but only picks up one. That is depressing. But not so much for Tempest Storm, who have made themselves a really nice entry onto mid, despite being a player down.
What can he do with it? Skadoodle is on the AWP now. But where is he to be found? I'm not even sure if he's announced it. Nothing still with the scouts. Nothing with the scout, not something you see every day.
Oh, wow.
Sean Grills just got taken to the freezer there by Stanislaw. 3v3 now, and Cloud9 have significantly inferior weaponry. They may have to rely on Skadonglers, but where is the man? He is sitting on a B-bomb site, and they are headed in his direction. You can see the gap he's created for himself on the site. Tempo Storm will have little choice but to announce themselves by popping the vent if they are to go into the B-bomb site. So here we go. Nothing may be able to run distraction while Skadonglers comes in with the frags. There's the first one onto Stanislaw. That flash will in fact stop him from being able to walk into that grenade. So Nothing's going to run out and get immediately taken down by Shazam.
Oh, but they're both pretty weak though. This is Freakazoid's chance. There's one shot. There's one opportunity, James.
Yeah, it is indeed. So he's looking for the second player in all the usual spots. He's going to find him, but not get the frag straight away. Now he needs to try and cross this window and see if he can find himself a frag onto the player that's in the sight. He's got a flash is coming out, and Glorian is going to shoot him straight in the head despite not being flashed. So very fast play by Glorian salvages the round for Tempo Storm. That could have definitely gone the way of Freakazoid and Cloud9.
Yeah, it looked like actually he realized, actually, I'm going to be past this flash. I don't need to turn. But then there seemed like there was a small amount of doubt, and then he did turn. I think if he was completely committed there, he gets the frag. Or should get, I mean, in theory.
Maybe. He got shot straight in the head, yeah. So it's hard to say.
Yeah, but he should have had a much better chance there. But it's going to be Cloud9 with a bit of a buy. Just a little bit of a buy. AWP on Skadoodle. So that where there is an AWP on Skadoodle, there is hope. Always. Shazam, once removed from Cloud9, is looking to do the damage with his AWP. Looking for some wall banks there. That AWP, just rattling off the shots like nobody's business.
He will keep a passive position, not going to walk up. Doesn't want to get pop flashed by the CTs. Hades with a nice shot through the corner of the forklift area to take down Freakazoid. So it's an early advantage here for Cloud9, going for the wallbang there on the usual angles where you can find CTs. This has caused the rotation, nothing coming deeper into the site now. Maybe fearing a push. Hades with the pop flashes over the door, and that will be the push from Tempest on through A main. Nothing getting taken down by Hades as well. He's looking for the third play. That's going to be Sean Garrett. He'll come in with a 5-7, and that's going to be all for him. Now, Shroud and Skadoodle.
Yeah.
Need to save.
This money for them is not too good. I swear, Skadoodle's name, it sounds like he's like the lead character in some cartoon series. Skadoodle. But he's deadly, James. This guy is very deadly.
Yeah, but unfortunately he won't get much opportunity on this round as the A site has been seized by the T's.
Well, that will definitely make life troublesome for Cloud9 here looking to save. And Tempest Storm would be really benefited by just going for these frags, and they are looking for them. But they will not find. Oh, very nice there by Skadoodle. Picks up an extra bit of damage at the end. That's always going to be nice. So it will force out a drop, actually, which is good for Cloud9. But behind this, are they going to go for the force here? They got two weapons saved, including an AWP on Skadoodle. So a force, hey, I mean, there would be a lot of teams that would go for that option. I don't think there's anything wrong with it, but they will actually go for the save. So where are we going to see Skadoodle play here? He is on the quad area. It's a very good area to hold down with an AWP, by yourself.
Okay, so Shroud's gone for a fast engagement towards the squeaky door area, and there's a bit of a conflict with him and another player, but it's going to be Shroud getting heavily tagged. Still unable to find a frag, but the aggression continues from the North American player. And that will cause a rotation of the bomb as Hades was the carrier. So Shroud will win for now. We'll see if he'll push a bit later on. You see, nothing's been left on the B bomb site, so they stacked the CTs over towards A, what remains of them anyway. And Tempest Storm looks like they might go for bit of mid presence, although they're still playing very passively indeed. You can see Shroud has moved up, so he can get the information for his team without exposing himself or overextending. And that might cause a rotation, spotting that player going in.
Nice, they're going to Molotov the NBK position there, just the corner behind the squeaky door, as they look to move it into the A site here, looking at and doing so quite successfully. But Shroud's going to come in from the side. He's going to pick up both kills, taking down the planter before the bomb gets dropped. And there's going to be two players left, Florian's and Shazam, but not for long. In comes nothing, but against Skadoodle and nothing, Shazam's looking to go huge. He's got the AWP, he's got 10 seconds to do something, but Skadoodle will silence him forevermore. As 3-3 will now be the scoreline, and Cloud9 actually managing to make that happen there. So, going to be a strong rebuy for them. Could see a drop out of nothing on Skadoodle. They're going to run the double orbs though. Sean Gares and Skadoodle on the orbs. So how will they do the setup? A and B perhaps? Looks like it. That is, I do love this. Then you can have three players in mid and really have a lot of pressure and fast rotation. That is the most awesome setup, I think. It's a really fun setup as also. But we have also just passive play here in middle, and it's going to have to be nothing. And Sean Gares to hold, and so far we're getting all the shots for nothing. And the bomb is going to go down by Stanislaw's hand, which is very nice, but defuse comes in.
Yeah, this is the kind of nothing we want to see on a consistent basis there, holding things down. That incendiary grenade came up very, very late indeed, but he still managed to savage the entire team. So, yeah, that's the nothing we want to see. Hopefully, with this new team, we'll see added focus and this will be a consistent thing. So, a nice hold there. That could have been very expensive for Cloud9, but in fact, it was relatively cheap. And you're losing Sean Grills there, and the AWP was safe.
We should get Cloud9 to also be coached by Joe Rogan. Do it. Alright, so we got 4-3 now. So Cloud9 are looking to really establish their economy. And we have Stanislaw and Glorious ready in A main, ready to push in behind the nades. Freakazoid in a very nice position though, spamming through towards Squeaky, gonna get caught on the drop down of the ladder. There's number two from Glorians. Stanislaw will find the fragments of Skadoodle. They get completely wiped out on the A bomb site. Sean Gares and Shroud looking for another save, and that was incredibly fast. Everyone died in a matter of seconds, and then there was nothing Sean Gares and Shroud could do.
Yeah, a bit of a shock to the system there. The money will still be able to allow them a buy. It's a nice boost at the back of the site there to look down short, but Cloud9 will be smarter than to try and push in this situation. And you can see the hunt, the swarm is heading their way.
Yeah, this is like a really hard situation indeed for them to deal with. So I have to see whether or not we can get another comeback here from Cloud9, because
well, through the gate, WrestleMania.
Yeah, this is actually really bad for Cloud9 right now. They keep getting resets, and of course they do have some cash to play with. But Tempo Storm in a position to actually take control of the match. And if they're able to get the momentum going, force the ecos out of Cloud9, even a double eco potentially, it is going to be very painful indeed. They need Cloud9, if they want to have a good CT half, they've got to establish themselves now, get the momentum going. But we're going to get fast pop flashes straight to Forklift from Glorious, goes in for the entries, and Cloud9 again looking like they're going to get shut down immediately.
Yeah, so that's going to be Skadoodle going down as well. Just Shock and Law. They're just being rushed here by Tempo Storm without warning, without any announcement. They're just coming in and taking all the jewels, all the family china, everything they can get their hands on. And Sean Gares and nothing will be in another spot where there's just not much they can do, and they're forced to retreat once again.
Yeah, it's very brutal indeed. We're going to have to see whether or not Tempo Storm can keep the momentum going though, because right now they just did it. They said, hey, rushing in just worked. Let's go for the end. And one of the reasons why that can actually be quite successful is generally speaking, teams very often do like to play a CT setup which is 1-3-1. So three players at mid at the start of the round. If you have a fast A timing, sure, for the CTs, the rotation to A is very quick. But if you manage to set yourself up and get really quick entries like we saw just happen, there is very little the CTs can actually do. So what they've done now is they've forced Cloud9 to consider, when on their next buy, more of a setup towards A at the start of the round, which means that middle will be more open, even if they have an AWP on their side. So I would presume Tempo Storm will go from mid take on their against when they're against the next CT buy. I'll have to see if that actually happens, but Cloud9 Cloud9 could be under the conditioning of Tempo Storm very soon.
It's a nice early opening frag from Shazam, and already Cloud9 are in a situation where they have no control over Checkers, trying to smoke things out. You see they're peeking for information and getting punished for the peek. It's not even Tempo Storm needing to be the aggressor now. Just punishing Cloud9 for rotating, punishing Cloud9 for trying to play for information. Shroud has brought a bomb down, which is going to be a crucial factor here. It's 1v3. We know what this man is capable of in these situations. And they're going to need to try and trade him. And that'll do the job. Rick's going to force him to look away from the flashbang and just find a frag as he tries to shield himself. Could not shield himself from the bullets, and it will be another round in the bag here for Tempo Storm, and Cloud9 will buy down to next to nothing once again.
Okay, so my expectation is a fast mid take, because Cloud9 should be a bit afraid of that fast days take that they've been doing. Is it going to happen? I don't know. Ah, damn it, James.
Skadoodle has no armor. Damn. He is AWP and nothing. He is running around in his boxer shorts
at
the moment.
It's totally fine. He's Skadoodle. He's got a good position, with only his head is showing anyway. So that is all well. However, that position, we're seeing that be Molotov more and more now, which is dangerous. Oh, Freakazoid is going to get pop flashed in here, but that's actually very dangerous. Shazam misses the shot. As, oh, Freakazoid gets the kill as well. The flash, when it goes in to a player that's AWPing that far away, the AWP doesn't get flashed. So very nice for him to pick up the frag there. And now they've got a good advantage. Glorenz and Stanislaw, they don't have a lot to work with. They're very far away from each other as well. We'll see the rotate though, so they can try to come together and see if they can make a play as brothers into the B-bomb site. But Skadoodle, he, I believe, will have their number with this AWP. Very good position. Even if you pre-fire it, Skadoodle will be ready. And Shroud is also ready to drop down, shoot some legs. And those will be legs that he will shoot. 5-2-6.
Okay, so Cloud9 trying to catch up now, but they have conceded a number of rounds already, and this is not an ideal situation for them. We'll see if they can right the ship. It's looking wobbly for now. Tempo Storm with a good T-half so far, but they will have their CT half to come, and they will have to hold. But for now, we head towards the end of the first half of the final few rounds here. And again, Hades with a nice pick, but he flicks his knife out. And he's one of those stupid ticks that people do for no reason, but we'll come back to that a bit later on. They've lost the bomb in the middle of the site as well. Trade's coming in for Tempo Storm. They've still got a man advantage. Still got a man advantage. And Stanislaw will get to the angle as the Cloud9 player is blind. So it's just down to Skadoodle and nothing to try and bring this round back. There will be three more rounds following this one. So they do have a decision to make with regards to these weapons. But it looks like they're committed for now. They don't have a kit, however, so they are limited to how much time they can spend on this push. Nothing doesn't get the frag, and neither does Rick. So, Hades got a frag, and then he pressed the QQ button, which is something that's been in pretty much every iteration of Counter-Strike. People just queuing, pressing the Q button to quick switch to their knife and bringing their gun back out again. Basically, for no reason. And he did it there, and it cost him a death. Fortunately for Tempo Storm, they won the round. However, it cost them a lot more money than it might have.
Yeah,
those kind of things can lose you rounds as well.
It's a discipline thing, and it definitely is quite needless. But we'll see Cloud9 already with a quick kill. Skadoodle finds Hades. Sean Gez finds Stanislaw. And all of a sudden, they are down men. A great flash in there for Sean Gez to pick up another kill. And Skadoodle wants some action as well. Goes for the spray. And it's not even going to matter. They just need to force them away from those weapons so that the T9 players can actually pick them up. And I think they're well aware of this. But what can they really do to stop it? We're going to have the AK picked up by nothing. And Skadoodle with a frag onto Glorenz. Just Rix left over. And they could survive with everybody. Rix has to do damage here. He has to get kills. He will only get one. And that is a hell of a lot of weaponry going towards Cloud9. Actually, they were only able to pick up one AK out of all of that, which is a little bit disappointing for them. But they survive with four players on basically a save, more or less.
Yeah, second last round of the half, so as long as this one goes their way, then it won't be a massive problem. Lots of mollies coming out for the CT side, so they're going to try and deny Tempo Storm those early picks, potentially. They've used one already, I think, into the boost spot, in fact. And they will use this time to boost. Shroud into the top.
I actually saw a wallbang from there's this Japanese player called Shoshi, and he showed a video where you can wallbang that spot where Shroud just boosted up to. There is an angle you can jump on like a locker or something or like a ledge, and you can just wallbang it. Did you know that, James?
I did not know that.
Yeah, you can just wallbang that spot, which is pretty interesting, because that is a really dangerous spot, and to be able to wallbang it for free is, I think, kind of cool. We'll have to see if more and more people learn about that. I don't know how often we will see it.
Yeah, it makes sense with the panels there.
Yeah, I can show it to you later. But we are going to have the push coming in now. Cloud9 Shroud, he's been in this spot before with worse. There is the first kill, just has to control, be composed, finds himself two kills before getting traded. They still have to deal with Skadoodle though, and he's going to take down Hades by the door. Trade comes in by the author of Tempo Storm, Shazam, and Ricks will get the bomb planted for his team. Oh, really? No. Oh, okay, he barely will actually get out of the Molotov. I think he went too far back, actually. And nothing is being chased down, but he should have this duel. There it is. Ricks will fall, and Cloud9 will win the round. So 7-7. Tempo Storm getting a bit nailed by that spot. And that's one of those spots where you can kind of crouch peek it from A main, but it's... the angles can be a little bit weird. If you like, for
which
example,
spot?
The spot where Shroud was.
Okay.
On the boxes, because the only problem though is that if they have an AWPer, obviously, he can shoot you from quads. I think so. You gotta be really careful.
Okay, so last round we're seeing double AWPs on the Cloud9 side again. Lots of Molotovs and Tempo Storm looking to rush once more. Sean going for the second kill, which would have cost him his life, but he won't find it anyway. Down to nothing now. He's been spotted. They've got the smoke for headshot to expose his legs, and Stanislaw will find the frag.
They are doing so much with these really fast pushes on the bomb side speed, because he's going to go in. They're going to line up a little bit, but he will only get a single kill. It's now up to the Wonder Kid Skadoodle with the AWP. Looking for a flex. Oh, what a shot there onto Rix. And now it's just Shazam and Stanislaw left. Pretty weak, but he's got an AWP. It's not going to matter anyway. Stanislaw will take the 8-7 for his team. Tempo Storm going to win the half, actually. And Cloud9 have a lot of work to do on their T side, to be honest.
That's quite nice.
It's really
that's
nice.
The first time that smoke onto the B bomb site, it's the first time I've seen in professional play, where it basically lands next to headshot, but on the bomb site itself. So players in headshot can't see anything, but you can see their legs. Yeah. Basically shoot them.
From checkers, right?
So, yeah. Yeah. Really, or really cool. From anywhere on the site, not just checkers. But yeah, that's quite nice. Anyway, one round lead for Tempo Storm, a paper thin lead. And they'll be looking for a successful pistol round here versus Cloud9, who are headed into the A site. But there is a three man flank, three musketeers, but they've got Glocks rather than rapiers.
We'll have to see what happens here. I mean, it could be very explosive right now if they don't get out of A main quickly enough. Oh, they'll barely just escape in time, but they'll still have no idea that these players are flanking, but the spot is going to come in. Will the information go to the team quickly enough? Three frags coming in from Tempo Storm, and the bomb is planted, but how much work can they do? Skadoodle won't find it with the burst fire, and it's going to be an easy cleanup for Tempo Storm. Now, that rush with the three players on B storage is very risky, but it pays off massively if they go A. It pays off so huge. If they actually go for B, or even for mid, if you don't hit the first shots with the Glocks, you're playing into the range of the Glocks basically very heavily. So you've got to hit the shots. But hey, if you're against a team you think is better than you shouldn't be making plays like this. That's like the correct thing to do.
That was a Tempo Storm, because they up the tempo, Dan, and then they cause the storm.
If I was writing, I would...
Acknowledge me.
That's like a dot, dot, dot. That's a...
Acknowledge me immediately.
No.
That was...
And you're complaining about my
awesome.
jokes earlier. My
puns. Oh, not just me, Dan. I saw your Twitter timeline.
You prompted it. You're encouraging them.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
All right.
But I do have an idea of this three-man push, which might come over mid from the Cloud9 side. They've gone for the force buy. They have a lot of flashbangs.
Nothing got...
Get your blindfold, people.
He's got the molly still. Not going to chuck it into the vent, though. All sandbags.
Flash photography coming up soon.
The paparazzi are here. This video is going to be popping Shazam with that tech knife. Just trying to be whack-a-mole there. will be successful. It's not going too badly, actually. They have compositioning onto the bomb site. This is nuts. Skuul trying to get himself onto the site, bunnying through a teammate. As he dies, he'll actually survive. And just Skadoodle is just barely escaping. He's like dodging and weaving through all the players like he's on a rugby pitch. And he's actually going to get the bomb plant. And right now, Tempo Storm, it's a 3-on-2. So this is really on with these positions for Cloud9.
Okay, so Tempo going to bring the lasers towards Cloud9. Skadoodle with the Tech 9 straight to the face. Traded by Glorinz. Sean Garrett, there's not enough time. Well, I mean, there's too much time for him to try and time waste. Got to find the frags. Glorinz will find the USP. Sean Grills will die.
How many have they lost in a row now? They've lost two in a row, so $14, $19, $2,400 if they lose this one. And they're going to be on an eco, so going to have quite a bit of money. Actually, they're opting to buy here, so that's fair as well. It can definitely go both ways. It depends how much you feel like you need an AWP against what the CTs are doing, I think. Because there are some spots where you'd be thinking where you're going to have a lack of grenades and weapons like this, where it's like, hey, if we had an AWP to pick, an AWP on Skadoodle no less.
Then it seems Tempo are expecting the eco just based on where Hades is playing. He's playing Kar
for
A main, and they've got nobody on A itself, which can only suggest that they're expecting an eco push, in my opinion. Let me know if you think I'm wrong.
No, I think you're right there.
But they have an announcement, and the announcement is from Skadoodle, and that is an AK to the face of Shazam.
He died.
So Cloud9 with significant presence in mid, and now it's their turn to wait for the CTs to go for the information play. However, the CTs have quite smartly abandoned mid for now, putting distance between them and the numbers of Cloud9. However, Rix is hungry for info.
He's a flash.
And he is going for a peek. And he could get two frags here. He will almost find two. He will escape with 12 HP and significant information. He's only seen two of the four players in the area, though. And we have nothing headed towards A main, where he may find a whole lot of nothing going on. No pun intended.
Yeah, it's a shame that Hades by Kar didn't have a flash there for that peek on mid, because he might have actually been able to get even more done. Just didn't have the money for that, but Shroud's gonna go in looking for those entries. Spots the first player, tap, tap, tap. That's the frag onto Hades, and we'll have the remainder of Tempo Storm. Probably considering whether it's even worth going for this retake. They can't have a lot of cash in the bank. Looks like they're gonna go for it though, and they have they got a couple kits. Are they just okay? They're going back now. Yeah, I think that's sensible, because if it was just two of them, it's a bit marginal, because you know you're not throwing away all that much, but with three players left alive, they can force up with the next two players.
Live to fight another day.
Or even drop and actually have a couple of famuses there. Let's check their money real quick. Okay, this will be the first loss. So, yeah, $1,400 for these guys. So we'll be able to see two famuses dropped for sure from the guys who are safe. Okay, one famus then. One famus can be dropped. So that's not too bad. Could be worse. But they need to win this round if they want to keep up the momentum. Otherwise, Cloud9 could really run away with this. And that surprise buy, that really, really, really got Tempo Storm. Because that setup just was not tailored for that. Giving up mid was too hard for them to deal with.
Okay, so Tempo Storm, two rounds to the good. But the economy is definitely to the bad. And we may have a... Oh, we've got a peek from the CTs actually coming into A main, it seems. Hades just toying with the smoke there, but the Cloud9 boys are going to head towards B. Looking for the B split, but the Molotov into vents will slow them down. And Glorinz has no idea what's behind him. Trades from Stanislaw, but the trade's going straight back in favor of Cloud9. That gives them control of the site, and they've got the nades down to cover the bottom of CT. And there'll be two CTs trying to get some more frags in before Cloud9 can get into post-plant positions. More trades coming in, but still not in favor of Tempo Storm. 2 versus 3.
Yeah, Rix is sitting on the box. He's trying to peer over the smoke, but...
On the box.
Even though he can see over the smoke, he's not going to find anything. And exits are the best case scenario, surely. But Hades picks up a quick kill, so now Rix is thinking, hey, it's on. Let's go for this. They have a kid on Rix as well. He's by a headshot. Oh, no. Catches Sean Gares off guard. Shroud comes in, and there is the defuse attempt. He has to peek to see if he's going to go for the hold. But Shroud is playing this perfectly right now, just going for the sidestep tap. And there's nothing Rix can do. He's going to have to fall away with the M4 and survive. But is he going to get wall banged? Oh, not quite. He did have a lot of health, so Shroud will die in the effort. But the round will be won by Cloud9, and a very important round indeed. And Zek Money will be booming at this point, and Tempo Storm, they are lacking funds to post a buy. They need to eco, and, well, it's not a fun life.
Round-winning maneuvers by Mr. Tyrone, a.k.a. Shroud, which is his secondary name.
Tyrone or Shroud?
Shroud, secondary name. Tyrone is his name.
Alright, we have the A play coming in as the B push from Tempo Storm is going to be with four players. So they went for the gamble. They're going to have to, I think they're going to settle for exits instead.
We have a, it's almost like a microorganism of CT players moving towards the Cloud9 team, but nothing has found all the information that Cloud9 require for them to push straight into the A site. They've lost the rifle, but at little cost. Tempo Storm only with two players. No armor. Hades does have a kit, but I can't see a bomb being defused unless it's a ninja. Actually, Cloud9 have moved quite far away from the bomb, but there's no way he could know that. He's got an AK as well, so there's no way he's going to go for this. But if those two players were the other way around, then I don't think Cloud9 checked Squeaky at all there.
I don't think so either, no.
They just completely abandoned the site. So even though it's worked out for them, this is that's a serious problem. Which
did a quick check just then, actually.
Yeah, but that's it could have been defused by then.
From Skadoodle. Skadoodle.
Yeah, that's
oh!
Something
oh, no.
Sean Grills needs to note because that is, and that could be a problem. You know.
That looks so scary right there. Like the flash comes in, he looks away. As there's three guys pushing him, that's scary. Okay, 10 to 10. It's all tied up. Cloud9 looking to reassert themselves on map number one. Here, Cash. Now, this was their choice as well. Let us note.
Biggest hand I ever lost was with a pair of 10s down. Big stack versus the second biggest stack. I just want you to know that.
All right.
Okay, so. Significant presence in mid from Tempo Storm. They've got three lads there. Lads! They've got the lads there. And they are firmly in control for now. We'll see if Cloud9 opt to mount an offense. That smoke, you can get a nice pop flash into that smoke by bouncing a flashbang off the red container. I know it's something that Existence the Titan does with his set solo smokes. Nades, or should I say. So basically what Nothing is doing here. Seems like he's going to throw out smoke himself. Alright, he's got a teammate to do it for him. Now, he's going to get a nice frag with the tiny gap that's there. Sandersaw's got a gap to try and find him. He's flashed, going to move himself, but he'll find the frag. Lucky for him, otherwise he might be in trouble, as Nothing would have known his location. So, he will get the frag there to even things up. There's 35 seconds on the clock, however, for Cloud9 to do something. Looks like something's going to be A. And the CTs are spread out all over the map. They found a bomb. Sandersaw with an important frag there, which will weaken the defense of this bomb plant here from Cloud9.
Yeah, they're closing in our Tempo Storm. Closing in. But there is no kits on any of them at the moment, so they cannot be slow. They must keep the pace high. Skadoodle by the red container, going to go for the peak. He gets taken down. Trey comes in from Shroud as Shazam hits the ground, but Glorians gets it done, and a defuse will come in for Tempo Storm. Now, let's check the money real quick of Cloud9, see how they are. Okay, so they get 800 for the bomb and 1400 for the loss. So they'll still be fine. They shall still be fine for a buy. But they'll be spending a lot of money in this round. So if they want to maintain the momentum and break Tempo Storm, this could be the round to do it because they will have forced out a lot of purchases. We can see that Tempo Storm are going to be buying within their limits, as are Cloud9. So this round is worth two pretty much for both teams. So, and we're at round 22 right now, so this is kind of where the momentum can win you the match. You know, this is that kind of point. So, not to see who can come out on top here. We've got the Tech 9 on Sean Gez, the Orb on Skadoodle, so pretty decent buy for Cloud9 actually. Really, Tempo Storm there suffering with that FAMAS. Sean Gez can be quite, he can provide a lot of utility. He can be the guy that dies, sacrifices himself for the cause. If he wants to, with that Tech 9. Now, passive play here from Cloud9. Two players in B storage, perhaps looking at a delayed mid take here for that B split as they are moving out from a Tempo Storm. They are playing incredibly passive at the moment. They have absolutely no information right now.
Yeah, and they are just going to sit and wait. And that's going to be another lack of information, the smokes, the wall of smokes in mid. including the roof there. They have no idea if somebody is going to go into the B-bomb site. And they're going to completely abandon the area and rotate straight away. Trade's coming in towards the B-bomb site, and they're going to know that the split is on. And a bit of a dink there, but the frag does come in for the T's. Bomb goes down, though, in an awkward place just before that smoke comes in. So the planche is still possible for Cloud9. 3 versus 3. Tempo Storm locked out of the site for now. But Cloud9 have a flash and nothing else left in the bank.
Absolutely. Rix again looking over the top of the smoke from the box as Nothing picks up the headshot. What a spin there from Nothing. Takes down Shazam as well, leaving Rix to his devices over on top of the box. Now, he will actually take down Sean Guest, but there's not much more he can really do. An interesting note in this round, we had, I think it was Glorens actually. He was in checkers defensively as a CT, of course, behind the crate at the end of the checkers room. You know which one I mean.
Yeah.
All right. So something we see from Happy of Envious is he, I don't know, this guy Happy, he always somehow is ahead in the mind games, because what I've seen him do from that position lately is he baits massively. And we actually saw that in that spot, if Glorens waits 2 seconds more before he peeks, he will probably shoot the back of 3 or 4 players. Because they actually were already turning away. They weren't checking this position at all. And maybe this is something that Happy actually noticed, because he started to actually destroy rounds by people just not checking that spot. He gambles on it, and it is successful. It's such a high percentage amount of time to build it. So you can have a really fast push here on B storage.
Oh, so dear. They were literally lined up like they were queuing for food rations, Dan. But all they were fed is cold steel.
That's not
that
cool.
They could not have been more lined up in this situation.
Yeah, this round could not have been more perfect for Tempo Storm. Cloud9 at risk now. They're at really big risk of losing this round. The bomb is in the control of the CTs. They've smoked it. It's been smoked off and everything. What on earth are Cloud9 going to do here?
What impact will this have on their money?
Look at this position from Rix. This is completely devious. It's such a hard position to deal with. Sean Gez is going to spot him and actually take him down straight away. Really well played by Cloud9, but Glorens, the angles for the CTs are too powerful. They even have a potential at the flank if they really want it. And that is sick. 3 players alive. That's 3 weapons for them, possibly. Only 2 picked up, though.
Yeah, that is a complete disaster for Cloud9. But the question is, how do they recover from this? They are in a situation where they cannot really buy. Although Nothing's going to go down to $1,800 with a purchase of a P250 and a flash. Sean Grill's going to carry the... Well, he's going to throw them onto Shroud, in fact. But he's got a smoke and 2 flashes. So it looks like they're going to go for a plant execute, which basically means, worst case scenario, they plant the bomb. Bonus is any kills they get afterwards. But Rix is in the back with a StatTrak P90. Death by Kitty edition, Dan. Rumor has it, the Death by Kitty does plus 10 damage versus Ecos and Force Buyers.
Nice. Got 2,653 kills on it.
That is just perverted. So, here it comes.
I have to see a new level of perversion here. Death by Kitty coming out from quad, smoke down, P90, it was made for this. Oh no! Oh, he gets annihilated straight away. That was the most anticlimactic thing I've ever seen in my entire life.
Man, we built that up like it was the Lord of the Rings finale, but it wasn't to be, Dan. The tape was lost on the train.
And right now it's looking like Cloud9, they are going to take this round back potentially. They are doing so much damage at the moment. The flames, they're burning them all down. It's Cloud9 with 2 players against the 3 that remain, and that P90 is cursed. There's nothing else to say other than that if you pick it up. Well,
I never thought I would see Skadoodle holding a Death Cup by Kitty P90.
Well,
this is not what you expect when you get up in the morning, Dan. But sometimes even the weirdest dreams can come true.
All right, 11 to 13, Tempo Storm on the verge of winning Cloud9's map choice. You know, the paper I was talking about earlier, James, that's been incinerated, and the ashes have been scattered
over the mountains,
across the 7 seas. And the mountains.
All right, Skadoodle is back with his righteous gun.
Flick of the wrist.
And he is unable to jump on his teammates. Shazam is admiring the smoke.
Who has the superior flick of the wrist? They both have orcs, or passables, in fact. We're about to see the duel of the century, James. Skadoodle surely will go. He's got a teammate to sacrifice himself in the run over the top first. Skadoodle's now got the angle, but Shazam's fallen back. This is not going to happen, James. It's not going to happen. Not yet, at least. We might see them clash at some point, but not right now. Not at the beginning of this round. But Cloud9 ready to go over the top in mid and potentially go for that B split play. We'll have to see how they use this. They don't have anyone in Squeak or A main, so it would suggest that they are looking for the B split. And we've got Sean Gez looking for a potential entry. He's just moving straight into the site, actually, at the moment. What position is Sean Gez in? He's very close. Now they are moving in for the split. And I'm curious if they do check that back box, actually. I don't think that they did. They just ran in again. So it's going to be Tempo Storm right now, picking up the kills. Got a 3-on-3. Cloud9 taking it nice and easy.
Ooh, just a millimeter away from the mouse one there to find that frag. It's going to be Rix to do it. That Molotov is not going to stop the bomb from going down. Nothing looking for another tight angle here. Shazam stuck in the corner for now. And they're going to do minimal damage to Rick. So it is a 2M4 and AWP retake here. Oh, the shot's going to be missed entirely by nothing. He had two targets to go. Couldn't find one of them. He picked up an AK, though. And it's 1v1. Rix has lost half his life with the jump, and he's still going to find the frag onto nothing and take Tempo Storm to round 14.
Oh, no. Those shots, actually. That actually cost them. Rix picked up a 4K. And sometimes it comes down to a single shot. And I think we saw two shots there that could have connected, but came up empty. And that was Tempo Storm saying, no, we're not going to let you get away with that. And it's 14-11, but still we have the buy-in from Cloud9. They have the potential to go for an execute here. They've got three smokes. Usually that's the minimum required for any kind of an execute. And you can certainly get it done on here. So you might see smoke for the toxic barrels, the back sights, and also to cover the plant spot towards, or the short peek to quad, and also the NBK position as well behind Squeaky. Now, Cloud9 are ready to go in here. Here we go. Is it going to be good, Jace?
We're about to find out. Shroud has made his way. Now, this is that tough smoke, which always causes problems for the T's, but they seem to be wrapping around the other side. That is fantastic from Shroud. He's going to clear the site for his teammates, who can now push through the smoke without losing a single player. That is exquisite stuff from the North American side. Three players remaining for Tempo Storm. Have a very quick look at their money, and it's a little bit tight, actually. So they've got a decision to make, and they have made their decision. Their decision is to save.
That the entries from Shroud there, that was really good. And the thing as well is that when he's moving into that position, like trying to wrap the player who's on the MBK spot, he is so exposed when he's doing that. I was really afraid for him that he would just die from a guy who's either on truck or on short, but he managed to get there really fast and he hit the shot straight away. So that was a really big risk from Shroud, but it won his team the round, and it won them the round cleanly. So important in this in these final rounds of cash. Cloud9 must win their map, because if it ends up going 1-1, if that's a possibility, and it goes to a dust two, anything can happen on dust two. It's the map of momentum, the map of comebacks, the map of upsets.
Okay, so Cloud9 with four rifles, no scopes on those rifles. And Cloud9 will be looking for Shazam's rifle. They will desire it, but will they find it? It's an aggressive nade from Tempo Storm. You don't normally see the Molotovs going in that deep. Did a bit of damage to Freakazoid there, but other than that, not much going on. But the pressure is real here. And the CT side will not give any inches to Cloud9. Got the flashes coming out for both teams. The counter flashes from the CTs and the flashes from the Ts. Nothing with a nice angle to take down Shazam there. Rick's going to get down, take down Shroud. And a flurry of frags come in for the Tempo Storm side. But they've only got the man advantage here. Things getting evened up by nothing. They're trying to try and stop the plant, however, with that Molotov. But they will announce their location at the same time. So, nothing. He's been playing very well this match so far. Taking down Stanislaw. Glorin's to bring it to a 1v1, and Freakazoid has to clutch here. He does not have much health. He does not have an AK. He needs a double dink here onto Glorin's from any distance, and he'll only get the one dink in, and he will leave Glorin's with 10 HP. If he had an AK, Dan, he wins the round.
There's
he had a Galil.
AK right there, James.
He loses.
But he can't afford to peek that wide for it. That's the problem. It's one of those spots. It's one of those situations. Oh, that is gutting. Again, this game, it comes down to the tiniest margins there. 10 HP, if that guy had been hit by a little bit, you know, a nade that went a little bit closer to him, just anything.
It's a game of millimeters.
It really is a game of millimeters. comes down to the smallest thing. And we're going to have 15 to 12 now. Tempo Storm on map points, game points, as they look to take an advantage in this best of three series. Now, if Cloud9 were to actually get knocked out by Tempo Storm in the HTC Reborn Invitational, it would be definitely quite the upset. I did not see the odds, but I can't imagine that they favor Tempo Storm all too much. Now, we have a slow play again from Cloud9 at the start of the round. Perhaps looking for those picks on mid. Skadoodle, can he deliver? We haven't seen a lot of round opening plays from Skadoodle with the AWP, I must say, on the T side. So could be they could find a way in future maybe to work that in a little bit more. We could see him looking for the picks on A. But Tempo Storm are not really peaking. They're not really playing a game where they are looking for jewels. They want the T's to come into their defensive setups. And with rounds like the previous one, you can see why. We've got nothing moving straight up mid right now. Good position for him for that A split.
Yeah, but there are three people. A triangle of doom around the A site, however. They seem to have just been relying on trust that they were not going to get flanked from mid. And they are going to get flanked from mid.
The time is starting to be an issue. And the bomb's going up short. So if it can't make it to the site, this could get bad for Cloud9.
Well, that's the first loss for them. And nothing will announce himself. So man advantage, but it gets quickly evened up by Ricks. And now the C2s are going to be in a position to go for a fast retake. Two from Car, one from Short. The bomb will just about get planted. Nothing going to even things up again. Two versus two, but Skadoodle only has 8 HP. We've got Molotovs going down as well. Nothing getting pressured, getting traded by Shazam. And now it's Shazam versus Skadoodle. Orp versus Orp. Mano a Mano. And Skadoodle's going to miss the shot again. He's only got 8 HP, and Shazam has picked up an M4 and a defuse kit. So Skadoodle needs to find a frag. He's not going to be able to do it. And it's going to be Tempo with a surprise game one here against the pick of Cloud9.
That's really impressive. They played really well, and wow, I didn't expect that. I absolutely did not expect that. I thought that this would be the match which had the clear favorite, but clearly I'm wrong. I mean, we talked about the you know, Cloud9 having two new players still, which is definitely, you know, you've got to bear that in mind. But, you know, massive props to Tempo Storm. They took it to Cloud9 on their map. We will be moving into Inferno as the next match, and we can take a quick look at the odds as well. So let's just take a look and see how. Yeah, that's how one-sided it is. That's how what I thought as well. I mean, the people who are value betting on this, they clearly.
Yeah, the thing is, with odds like this, you have to put all the Asimovs on Dan to make a profit.
Yeah.
So, but hey, it's the best of three. It's only one map. Who knows what's going to happen in the second?
All right, guys, we're going to take a quick little break here for the HTC Reborn Invitational whilst we take a breather and get us map two set up. It's going to be Inferno, which is the choice of Tempo Storm. So we could very well bear witness to quite an upset in the quarterfinal stages. We'll find out.